buried among the kings. 2 Chronicles chapter 24, verses 15 and 16. But Jehoiada waxed old and was full of days when he died. 130 years old was he when he died. And they buried him in the city of David among the kings, because he had done good in Israel, both toward God and toward his house. There is a special lesson in this scripture for Christians who believe that they cannot be honorable in the sight of God except they become ordained as pastor, deacon, archbishop, general overseer, and so on. Jehoiada was not a king. He was a priest. Now, if you ask any Christian today about someone like Abraham, Moses, Samuel, King David, or Elijah, he or she would most likely have a lot to say. But ask about Jehoiada, and many will tell you that they are not even aware that there is any such name mentioned in the Bible. However, this priest, that is not as popular as many other Bible characters, played a wonderful role in Judah that earned him a spot in the burial place reserved only for kings. After the death of King Ahaziah of Judah, his wicked mother, Athaliah, began to wipe out the whole royal house of Judah and ascended the throne. Now, according to 2 Chronicles 22, verses 11 and 12, Jehosheba went and got Joash, the son of Ahaziah. She was the daughter of King Jehoram. She stole Joash away from among the royal princes. All of them were about to be murdered. She put Joash and his nurse in the bedroom. Jehosheba, the daughter of King Jehoram, was the wife of the priest Jehoiada. She was also Ahaziah's sister. So Jehosheba hid the child, that is Joash, from Athaliah. That's why Athaliah couldn't kill him. The child remained hidden with the priest and his wife at God's temple for 6 years. Athaliah ruled over the land during that time. Note that Jehoiada did not have a nonchalant attitude towards Athaliah and the impact of her wickedness on God's people. He quietly brought up Joash, set him on the throne at the right time, and commanded that Athaliah be killed. We are also told in 2 Chronicles 23 verse 16 that Jehoiada made an agreement with all the people and with the young king that they all would be the Lord's people. The people also tore down the temple of Baal, broke the altars and idols that were in the temple, and killed the priest of Baal. Jehoiada was counselor, instructor, mentor, teacher, and so on to young King Joash, and according to 2 Chronicles 24 verse 2, Joash did what was right in the eyes of the Lord as long as Jehoiada was alive. Jehoiada was a very good influence not only on King Joash but on all his people. And as a result of the actions of Jehoiada, 2 Chronicles 23 verse 21 says that all the people of Judah were very happy and the city of Jerusalem had peace. Now, after the death of Jehoiada, King Joash, following evil counsel from the elders of his people, turned his back on the Lord. Both Joash and his people began to worship idols. They turned deaf ears to the prophets that the Lord sent to restore them. And when Zechariah, the son of Jehoiada, informed the people of Judah about God's impending judgment on them for their sinful ways, Joash commanded that he should be killed. Now compare the end of King Joash to that of Jehoiada, the priest. 2 Chronicles 24, verses 23 to 25. And it came to pass at the end of the year that the host of Syria came up against him, that is, against Joash. And they came to Judah and Jerusalem and destroyed all the princes of the people from among the people and sent all the spoil of them unto the king of Damascus. For the army of the Syrians came with a small company of men, and the Lord delivered a very great host, that is the host of Judah, into their hand, because Judah had forsaken the Lord God of their fathers. So they executed judgment against Joash, and when they were departed from him, for they left him in great diseases, his own servants conspired against him for the blood of the sons of Jehoiada the priest, and slew him on his bed, and he died. And they buried him in the city of David, but they did not bury him in the sepulchres of the king. Jehoiada the priest was buried among the kings, whereas Joash, who was actually a king, was not given that honor. Consider also the case of Ahaz, king of Judah. 2 Chronicles 28, verses 24 to 27. And Ahaz gathered together the vessels of the house of God, and cut in pieces the vessels of the house of God, and shut up the doors of the house of the Lord, and he made him altars in every corner of Jerusalem. And in every several city of Judah, he made high places to burn incense unto other gods, and provoked to anger the Lord God of his fathers. Now the rest of his acts and of all his ways, first and last, behold, they are written in the book of the kings of Judah and Israel. And Ahaz died, and they buried him in the city, even in Jerusalem. But they did not bring him into the sepulchres of the kings of Israel. And Hezekiah his son reigned in his stead. So, even though Ahaz was a king, he was not accorded the honor of being buried among the kings. Many Christians today see holding church titles and positions as a definite assurance of being honorable before God and man. Some will go to any length to get these titles and then end up either not doing the work associated with the titles or doing the work with filthy hands. What these people do not seem to realize is that God is not moved by titles, but he is looking at our lifestyle and our works. How much glory does your life give to God? How does your life influence others? How committed are you to God's work? Does your conduct in the ministry challenge people around you to be more committed to God's things, or does it teach laziness to them? Learn from the examples of Jehoiada, Joash, and Ahaz that you do not need to occupy certain positions in church before God can honor you. Also, occupying a particular position does not guarantee that God will have respect for you. Paul said in Galatians chapter 6, verses 7 and 8, "Be not deceived, God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. For he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption, but he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting." Also in 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 30, the Lord said that he would honor those that honor him and turn away from those who disrespect him. Jehoiada was buried among the kings even though he was not a king. You do not need church ordination or title to be honored by God. Just give him the pleasure for which he created you and be a channel of blessing to others. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name.